What did Starfleet Command say?
How many reinforcements will they be sending?
And how soon will they get here?
We're not getting any reinforcements. We'll have to make do with what we've got.
What we've got isn't enough.
Sir, as Strategic Operations Officer, I cannot guarantee the safety of the station if a Dominion fleet attacks.
Your concerns are noted, Commander.
What's Starfleet thinking? They must have given you a reason for denying your request.
They did.
And?
I'm not at liberty to discuss it. Let's just say Starfleet's resources will be needed elsewhere.
What could be more important than defending this station?
That is not for us to decide. What are our orders, Captain?
Deploy the minefield and prepare for a Dominion attack.
And when the attack comes?
Then we are to defend the station until the mines are in position and the field has been activated.
The Defiant will be unable to raise shields or cloak while deploying the mines. She will be an easy target.
Then it's up to DS9 to defend her. If the Dominion wants to stop the Defiant, they'll have to come through us.
Captain's log, Stardate 50975.2. The next Jem'Hadar convoy is due in 5 days, but our efforts to mine the wormhole have already provoked a response from the Dominion, who have sent their Vorta Ambassador Weyoun to speak with me.
What can I do for you, Weyoun?
Captain Sisko. I'll make this brief. We know all about the minefield.
I assumed you'd find out sooner or later.
As I see it, you have two choices. Either you remove the mines, or we will take this station from you and remove them ourselves.
I appreciate your directness. Now let me be direct with you. The mines stay. I will not allow any more Dominion reinforcements through the wormhole.
You will not allow?
You heard me.
I can see how that might be your first reaction. But you and I are reasonable men, and surely reasonable men can come to some sort of mutually acceptable compromise.
I didn't think the Dominion believed in compromise.
It saddens me to see how deeply you misunderstand us. All the Dominion wants is to peacefully coexist with its neighbors.
Then why the continued military buildup? Why the weekly convoys of ships and troops from the Gamma Quadrant?
It's the Cardassians. Don't get me wrong. I'm pleased to call them allies, but as you know, they've just been through a terrible war with the Klingons. I'm afraid it's left them somewhat jittery. So they're understandably concerned about ensuring the sovereignty of their borders, and since they're now members of the Dominion, their concerns have become our concerns.
I would think by now you have more than enough ships to defend Cardassia.
You may think that, and I may think that, but the Cardassians...
Oh, yes, I know. They're jittery.
You see our dilemma.
I'm beginning to.
What if we agreed to limit our convoys to cargo ships, construction units, civilian aid, things that will help them get their economy back on its feet? Did you know when we arrived, children were starving on Cardassia Prime? It was heartbreaking.
I had no idea things were so bad.
The Cardassians are very proud people. They don't want to admit to outsiders how dire the situation really is. So, while we agreed, you remove the mines, and we restrict our convoys to medical and economic assistance.
That sounds reasonable. I'd have to discuss it with Starfleet first, of course.
I'm sure they'll do whatever Benjamin Sisko recommends. For my part, I'll personally speak to the Founders to secure our end of the bargain.
What about Gul Dukat?
Ah, he'll be furious. At first. But we've developed a fine working relationship, and I'm sure I can help him to see the wisdom of our decision.
I will leave it in your capable hands.
You won't be disappointed. This is a momentous day. You and I have just taken the first step towards ensuring peace between our peoples.